said that the pleasure of a double life lies in the thrill of the secret. But eventually, secrets must come out. 57-year-old businessman Mark has been living a double life since childhood. He's part of an underground subculture so secret, most people don't even know it exists. But Mark's had enough of hiding away. Tonight, Mark's finally coming out of the closet. It's time to let the world know that he's a mummy. Mark's inspiration comes from the ancient Egyptians, who began practicing mummification about 5,000 years ago. It wasn't until the 1930s that mummies made it into the modern consciousness.
Spawned from the depths of doom.
Courtesy of a series of horror movies.
To strike with paralyzing terror.
Unsurprisingly, a favorite genre of Mark's.
I loved the old mummy movies with Boris Karloff, especially seeing him being wrapped alive and then put into the sarcophagus.
But mummies as a fetish only came to life in 1978 when Jim Stewart, an English bondage enthusiast, developed these leather sleep sacks for the BDSM scene in San Francisco. The future of mummification was in the bag, so to speak.
One reason that mummification would be secretive is that it is a sexual trip for some people. There's no question about it. There's a sensate element to it, and it can easily be eroticized. But not everyone has that experience with mummification. Instead of erotic charge, they can also feel a sort of spiritual or meditative state.
For Mark, it was once a kink that's now been smoothed out.
Over the years, the sexual aspect has been more diminished and downplayed, and it's become more of a therapeutic type of pursuit for me.
Total mummification takes between 30 and 40 minutes. Mark will remain like this all night long.
I think one of the reasons that people, if you like, are so afraid of mummification is you're talking about an experience where somebody might be totally bound up, they can't move. To all intents and purposes, you're almost dead.
Mainly, I will breathe through my nose. I want every sense to be deprived or taken away, including the ability to speak or communicate.